I hope you're having a great day and I hope you're staying safe at home. One of the most Googled words are fat loss, how to lose weight, how to burn fat. And while the world continues to chase more fat diets and more fat exercise programs, we need to understand that the body, the human body, works on the principles of physiology, biology, chemistry. Everything is not about a piece of paper that tells you what food to eat, how much to eat, and at what time. You know, we got to expand our thinking beyond just a piece of paper, which is a diet plan, beyond just the exercises that we put our body through. Today, I want to talk about something that you already have within you and how you can activate it to burn excessive belly fat. And not just that, because good human health and life shouldn't have to just be around how much of weight you can lose and how much of fat you can burn. Yes, everyone wants to look good. And yes, there are a ton of good looking people, but extremely shallow, rude, you know, bad attitudes, unkind to people and all of that stuff. So just looking good isn't enough anymore. Looking good with a great attitude is fine. Not looking good, but having a great attitude and a pleasing personality is rich. My whole point is today, how do we activate something called HGH, which is your human growth hormone that you already have within you. But because of your poor lifestyle, it's suppressed and you don't get to use it. Yes, there are some conditions where the pituitary gland, which produces human growth hormone and other hormones, there are certain diseases that cause you to have an insufficiency, but that's very, very few. For everyone else, while you're beating up your body with diets and fat exercise programs, most of y'all have suppressed HGH. And without the right amount of HGH, which is your human growth hormone, you find it difficult to burn fat. In fact, you will put on fat. And where? The area around your belly, the midriff, all around you. You know what they call love handles and tires? That's where you're gonna put on that kind of fat, a lot of fat, which hangs off the side of your body. And you'll say, I'm dieting, I'm working out, I'm doing all of that stuff, but I still have that problem. Again, everything in the human body is controlled by hormones. Hormones are chemical messengers that communicate constantly, telling your body what to do, telling your body when to burn fat, telling your body when to increase energy, telling your body when to go to sleep, telling your body when to eat sugar or carbs or protein. So if your chemical messengers are sending the wrong messages, you have health problems. If your chemical messengers, which are your hormones, are sending the right messages, you have great health. Let's understand more about HGH, because it's not just about fat loss. It's about muscle gain as well. A lot of people out there take more protein to build more muscle. But guess what? If you activate HGH, you can automatically improve your muscle tone in your body. HGH is produced in the pituitary gland. It is responsible for your growth. As you're a child, when you're an infant, you grow into a child, your human growth hormone is required for your bone length. It is required for your height. It is required for your muscular growth. So all athletes who are muscular, lean muscular, they have high amounts of HGH. Of course, you have artificial and synthetic human growth hormone injections today, which a lot of young kids and people overuse for their bodies, and then you have side effects. If you are doing HGH injections, make sure it's done under supervision, because you can have severe side effects. Now, it's also required for your body composition. So if you have the right amount of HGH, you have the right amount of body composition. It's required for cell repair. It's a growth hormone that helps your body repair your cells. So if you have DNA destruction happening, you're recovering from an injury, you're recovering from a surgery, you're recovering from deadly diseases like cancers, Alzheimer's, and all of these things, you need HGH to help your cells repair, to help your cells grow. It's required for muscle growth. You could be lifting the heaviest weights, you could be having the most protein, but if your HGH levels are low because of your lifestyle, simple lifestyle tip like you're sleep deprived, but you're training hard, HGH will be low. You will not be getting the results that you need. You need it for exercise performance. So a lot of young kids come to us, they want to get better at football, cricket. We have cricket players coming to us and they say, Luke, we're good at our game, but we don't have energy. Their HGH levels are low. And then you help them to change their lifestyle, eat the right foods, and the HGH goes up. And mainly for recovery from diseases. Whenever you have a disease, it involves your cell. Every disease is born out of a cell. So if your cells are unable to repair themselves, okay, you don't get better, or your recovery process is extremely long. For that, we need HGH. Let me give you a simple example of a patient going through cancer. It's a toxic treatment. Okay, but it's a treatment that you may require. But while you do this, the cells start to die. They start to get inflamed and injured. And if your HGH isn't good enough, you can't repair them. That's why some cancer patients recover quickly, and some for years, they continue to have neuropathy, they continue to have bone pain, joint pain, and all of these issues. So you see, when you're trying to recover, you need the basics. Yes, you need medicine, but you also need the right foods and the right lifestyle so you can activate HGH that helps you. Now, what happens if you have low levels of human growth hormone? Number one, you decrease the quality of your life immediately, whether you're a teenager, a young adult, or a senior citizen. If you have low levels or your body cannot activate the right amounts of HGH, you decrease the quality of your life. You increase the risk of disease. Because if your body doesn't have the ability to repair itself, you become more vulnerable to viruses, bacteria, inflammation, and everything else. Fat gain, like I said, low HGH, more fat gain. Osteoporosis. You are at a higher risk of osteoporosis if your HGH levels are low, fatigue, depression, memory loss, and overall increase in body fat if your HGH is low. Now, typically, a normal, healthy, functioning body, the pituitary gland, should produce enough of HGH for you. But because of our poor lifestyle, we reduce it or we suppress it. Let's get straight into the lifestyle changes that can help you to boost your HGH. Number one, intermittent fasting. If you're constantly eating throughout the day, low HGH. If you can try to keep 4 hours gaps between every meal you eat without snacking, HGH rises. Intermittent fasting, circadian rhythm fasting, will also boost your HGH. But fasting that's done for a very, very long period, like over 4 days, 5 days as a fad, can actually decrease. So HGH. So the whole idea of human growth hormone is keep gaps. Try to finish your dinner early so at least you keep a 12 to 13 to 14 hour gap between your next meal. That is the time that HGH will boost. And why that's important for you is it's linked with the second point. If you have late night meals close to your bedtime, HGH falls. So you want to have an earlier dinner that gives you a longer fasting gap and an increase in human growth hormone. So late night meals closer to bedtime, or even if you eat at 8 o'clock and sleep at 9 o'clock, your human growth hormone ability is going to be suppressed. So you want to keep a nice gap of at least dinner and your bedtime. Extremely important for HGH to work the right way. Okay. Compound movements, weight training is excellent. Using your own body weight or using weights in a gym or at home will boost your HGH. Compound movements like squats, bench press, pull-ups, holding planks, lunges, push-ups, all of these are movements that engage multiple muscles. The more multiple muscles you engage, the higher your HGH. So yes, body weight training will also help you with that. High interval training for 4 minutes intensely, 8 minutes, 12 minutes, 14 minutes, something called Tabata. Tabata is a great HIIT example which will boost your HGH. So short bursts of interval runs, interval jogs, interval mountain climbers, interval squats, all of these things. So you do 20 seconds, go all out, take a 10 second break. 20 seconds, go all out, take a 10 second break. If you can do these small, short boosts of, you know, workouts every alternate day, it is great for your HGH as well. Sleep, the most important thing. If you're sleep deprived, you sleep lightly, you wake up tired in the morning, HGH is suppressed. Which is why athletes, they can train a lot and have muscular bodies because they rest equally. The more they train, the more they sleep. If you are overtraining and under recovering, you are overtraining and under sleeping, your HGH will be right down. So you may get fit in all parts of your body, but you'll have that pot belly or that midriff fat that never seems to go because your human growth hormone is suppressed. Then you have an amino acid called L-arginine. Now L-arginine, you can have it in supplement form, but there are natural foods as well. You find it in all non-vegetarian, whether it's your fish, your meat, your dairy, your legumes, your lentils, your dals, your pumpkin seeds, sunflower seeds, almonds, cashew nuts, walnuts. So a lot of them, especially chickpeas. So if you like hummus, make a lot of hummus and have that almost every alternate day. It is a rich source of L-arginine, which can help you with your human growth hormone. Then we have melatonin. Melatonin is another hormone that puts us to sleep. But if you have less melatonin because you're looking at your phone right before sleep, blue light basically suppresses melatonin. Melatonin is required for human growth hormone to be at its highest. So whether you're taking a melatonin supplement or you're keeping your gadgets off 1 hour before bedtime, not exposing yourself to blue light, that will increase your melatonin. Or you have melatonin-rich foods, which are the same as the arginine foods. Your legumes, your nuts, your lentils, your dairy, your cheeses, your yogurts. All of these natural foods can basically help you produce more melatonin through a precursor hormone called tryptophan. So that's how it works. Everything is interconnected in the human body. So good sleep means better growth hormones. That's why you heal while you sleep. Because while you sleep, while you're in deep sleep, your human growth hormone gets up. That's why it can repair your cells, repair your wounds, repair cell damage, grow, help you. People who are diabetic naturally have low HGH, which is why it is so important for people with type 2 diabetes. Change your lifestyle, reverse your diabetes. Because as long as you're diabetic, you will always have low HGH, which means your body has less of a mechanism that can protect you. So it's not okay living with diabetes. Try your best. Maybe a few people have to, but most people don't have to. If you're willing to change your lifestyle, reverse your type 2 diabetes so you can automatically activate HGH for a long, quality, healthy life. Then we have something, there are other foods as well. You have mustard seeds. We spoke about this the other day. Mustard seeds are rich in foods that can help your HGH grow. You have eggs, the whole egg, not just the white, but with the yolk. Cooked tomatoes as well. Your nuts, your seeds, your beans, meats, and legumes. So if you're having a balanced diet, you have everything that your pituitary gland requires for the production of HGH. So you see, rather than adding more foods, see what you're doing that suppresses HGH. Lack of sleep, sedentary lifestyle, too much of stress will suppress HGH. That's why only when the body's in a state of complete calm and deep rest that HGH starts getting produced. So you see, it comes down to your lifestyle. So stop beating up yourself with exercise programs, which are fads, where you injure yourself. HGH helps you recover from injuries. So if you're constantly getting injured and not recovering, you don't have the right amount of HGH. You can do all the physiotherapy in the world, have all the turmeric in the world, anti-inflammatory foods, but you will not get better if you don't have the human growth hormone, whose responsibility it is to repair your injured cells, reduce inflammation, and keep you healthy. So HGH plays a huge role with your immune system as well. Understand these things and make these simple lifestyle changes so you activate the intelligence of your own body to protect you, to heal you, to help you recover. Have a great day, everyone. Until next time, eat smart, move more, sleep right, and breathe deep. And remember, you care is all about you.